You don't need to pay someone to create a PayPal account for you. You can do this all by yourself. If you are in Nigeria, you discover that when you visit paypal.com, it redirects you to paypal.com/ng. For Nigerians, you can only create a PayPal account that can only send money but cannot receive money. In this video, I will show you how to create a PayPal account that can send and receive money here in Nigeria. If you watch this video to the end, you'll be able to create your own PayPal account and also receive your money right into your local bank account. Yes, into your local bank account. You don't need a prepaid card to receive your money from PayPal. You can receive your money using that your local bank debit card. Whichever bank you are working with, you can use the debit card to withdraw your money. So stay tuned for that. Before we get into the video, you should know that there are two kinds of accounts you can create on PayPal. You've got the personal account and the business account. With the personal account, you can shop in your own country and worldwide from your computer or mobile device, all without disclosing your financial information to the sellers. This is the only type of account available in Nigeria. Nigerians can only shop and send money with their PayPal account. The business account gives you many more options than the personal account. You can accept payments and send invoices to your customers with a business account. It's easier and more secure to sell to anyone, anywhere at any time. So how do you create a business account since the business account is not available in Nigeria? So how will you now create a business account? So all you have to do is go visit the URL of your country where the business account is available. You know, like I said earlier, when you visit paypal.com, it redirects you to paypal.com/ng. So you just have to bring a slash another country. For this video, you can just use slash. You can just make a slash LS for Lesotho or slash AE, whichever country comes to your mind, and you know that PayPal business account is available there. You can use those country. For this tutorial, I'll just go to paypal.com/LS. So I'll just visit the paypal.com/LS. You see the interface here is different from what you see in the other in the Nigeria website. Now you now have a personal and a business account. So I'll just click on sign up. So when you get there, you choose business account, then continue. Now you have to enter your email address. So I'll enter my email address, victortomilobasmith@gmail.com. So I click continue. Now it's asking you to create a password. So you have to create a very strong password. A strong password containing characters between 8 to 20 characters, uppercase and lowercase, and also a number or a symbol. So I will continue after creating the password. Now it's telling us to tell us about your business. So you want to try to say everything about your business. All the details about your business will be included here. So I'll enter my name and my surname. Also my business name. So I'll just go with the name of my website, Low Overdraft. Now here where it says business phone number, just change the country. You know you are in Lesotho, so just change the country to Nigeria and put your Nigeria number there. So I'll just look for Nigeria here, then I'll enter my Nigeria phone number and now business address. So I'll enter my business address and continue. So I just have to skip this part of the video. And when I'm done with it, I'll hit continue. Also, you have to choose your primary currency. So, look, I'm gibberish address, just some address that does not exist for now. Then you enter your postal code and also the currency you are using, and then you click continue. So I'll click on agree and continue. Agree, continue. So if you don't know your postal code, you can just look for your, this is how to check your postal code. If you don't know your postal code, just any country you are seeing, you can just search for postal code for Ikeja, anywhere you are located, you can search for your postal code online. Just include your postal code in your address. So let us continue with the website business, describe your business. So what describe your business. So what business is this? You can pick any of these. So I'll go with individual or proprietorship. And if you're a partnership business, you can just choose partnership. So you can just put any keyword you like here. Just some any keyword you prefer. I'll just go with digital groups, media and all that. So this is an optional part. If you have a website, you can include it. You can include it here. And if you don't, you can just skip this process. So I'll just enter my website here. And as you can as well skip the process. So tell us more about you. So it's asking to tell you to say about yourself. So you have to put your date of birth, your identity document. Yeah, you can have to put your identity document. If your home address is also your business address, just hit click on this button here. So just have to put your date of birth and your identity document. I guess your let me just put any first. Then your identity document. You can use national ID card, passport, or your national ID card, your passport, or your international passport as well. So you can just enter your national ID card. I'll just enter any number here because these are not necessary now, but at some point you might be asked to verify all this, verify your identity. But I'll just put in any number here. Now tell us more about you. Okay, loading. Now you have successfully created a PayPal account. Your PayPal account should be up and running. So you say if you want to take it all, you can just click OK and leave that side. So this is a PayPal account. With this PayPal account, you can send and receive money right here in Nigeria. So you have things you have to do. You have to confirm your email address. So you just have to visit your email to see the. So you can see they've already sent a confirmation email to me. So you just have to click on this and then just click verify the email address just to activate your email. Email address verification is very, 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 very important. So you have to verify your email address. So I'll click on confirm your email. Then you enter your password and your email address will be verified for you. After the email verification, you can start receiving your money into your PayPal account. You can send and you can receive money into this PayPal account and everything should be working fine, even though you have not verified your PayPal account. Let me show you the PayPal account I use. Alright, here's the PayPal account I've been using for quite some time now, and with this PayPal account I've been using the PayPal account for like more than 3 years now, and as you can see that I've received a lot from the PayPal account, and yet I haven't verified my debit card or credit card. This PayPal account is not verified, and I've been receiving money from since back in 2021 or 2020 or so. Yeah, I think 2020. Yes, I've been receiving money into this PayPal account since 2020, and I've not verified the account. Although I have a limit, PayPal will give you a limit to which you can use this account. Like if I go to my account, I can view my limits when I go to money, banks and cards. I have a preset limit, or I can't actually find it, but you can see here I linked my Visa debit card. This is the card I'll be using to receive money into my PayPal account. This is my Access Visa card. So I've actually used Access and Access Visa card and First Bank MasterCard. These are the two cards that I've tried using in receiving money to my account. So you can try it. In fact, you can even use your own part, the bank you are using now, right now. Maybe you are using a Wema Bank, UBA Bank, whichever bank. You can try using it to withdraw from your PayPal just to see if it will work. If it works, I would like to know in the comment section below. But I've been using Access Visa card, and I've also used First Bank MasterCard, and these two cards worked. I've been able to use it to receive money into my PayPal account. So you don't even need a prepaid card. Although you cannot use this Access Visa card or your First Bank MasterCard to verify your PayPal account. Yes, when you try to verify your PayPal account with this, the money will be withdrawn from your card, but you won't receive the code, the verification code. So you cannot receive the, you won't receive the verification code into your card, but into your, in your bank, then transaction details, but you cannot use to verify your account, but you can use to receive money into your account. And I'll be using this account now, but I think I have a preset limit. I don't seem to get to see. Let me check his account preferences. I have a preset limit whereby I have limits, but the limit is just the amount I can withdraw from my bank, from my ATM card. But I can, did not give me any limits on the amount I can receive. So I've not received, I've received more than $5,000 into this account without even verifying my debit account. But I'll verify my debit account very soon. So if you want to check the video, subscribe to the channel so that you can, you'll get notified whenever I drop the video on how to verify the your PayPal account. So that's it. You can, with this account, you can send money, you can receive money here in Nigeria, and you can withdraw the money into your bank, into your personal bank account, your local bank account. The money can be withdrawn to your local bank account. If you already have a Nigeria PayPal account that can only send money and you want to switch, check the video in the card above right here on how to cancel your current PayPal account. I've also placed the link in the description below. So you have to cancel your current PayPal account, then so you can use that same email to open a PayPal account that can receive money. Also, if you want to know how to verify your PayPal account, I would like you to subscribe to the channel so that you can get the video you can get to know when I publish the video. So that's it for this video. If you find the video helpful, I would like you to subscribe to the channel and also hit the bell button to get more videos like this. My name is Victor Smith. See you in the next one.